I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Wear red for good luck. Wildcats Tuesday is Lunar New Year celebration. There'll be fun activities to do all over the school. Wear red for good luck. Black History Month continues. Today's spotlight is on Marcus Garvey.
Marcus Garvey wanted to return African Americans to Africa to create a vibrant black nation, empowered through economic independence. Although some of his goals were controversial, his crusade would inspire leaders from Malcolm X to Martin Luther King and Nelson Mandela.
Garvey was certainly a controversial figure, but the concepts that we now think of as black nationalism and black pride started with Garvey's pronouncements.
Marcus Mosiah Garvey was born in St. Anne's Bay, Jamaica, on August 17, 1887. Beginning as a printer's apprentice at 14, Garvey became a union organizer and later worked various jobs across Central America.
Marcus Garvey found wherever he went, black people of African heritage in particular were always on the lower stratification end of society. This had a profound impact on him. Particularly, his concern was for the uplift of African people globally.
In 1912, Garvey sailed to London, England, and took night courses at Birkbeck College. After working for a Pan-African newspaper, Garvey returned to Jamaica in 1914 and formed the United Negro Improvement Association, or UNIA.
The UNIA was about black self-determination. It was about galvanizing the ideas of black repatriation to the motherland, the continent of Africa. And it was extremely important in terms of getting black people to understand self-pride, pride in one's race.
Inspired by Booker T. Washington to raise funds and start his own school, Garvey came to the United States in 1916, and in 1918 began publishing the Negro World newspaper.
Garvey was extremely outspoken. He was, some people would say, almost bombastic. He wanted to take over Africa and had elected himself as president of Africa without consulting the Africans, unfortunately.
Determined to achieve economic independence for African Americans, Garvey launched the Negroes Factories Association in 1919 and a shipping company called the Black Star Line, which he planned to use to transport passengers back to Africa.
Garvey was a great organizer, but unfortunately not a great businessman. During the time that Garvey and the UNIA were trying to launch the Black Star Line, they solicited funds from investors for stock options through the mail. And this resulted later on in allegations of mail fraud, and Garvey was convicted and sent to prison.
After serving 5 years in prison, Garvey was deported. He eventually moved to London, and in 1938, he supported the Greater Liberia Act, created by known white supremacist, Senator Theodore Bilbo from Mississippi.
Marcus Garvey's association with Senator Bilbo is related more on a practical level rather than an intellectual like for each other. Marcus Garvey's attempt to help Africans in America leave and go to Africa fell in line with some aspects of KKK philosophy.
Garvey died in London on June 10, 1940. He was reinterred in Jamaica in 1964 and is hailed as Jamaica's first national hero and the prophet of the Rastafarian religion.
Although Garvey was a flawed leader, he's someone who is really important to the history of the black radical tradition. He was probably one of the strongest voices of black nationalism in history.
Winter Wonderland Dance has been rescheduled for February 8th, this Friday, 6 to 8 p.m.
G.I. Joe!